Hi you guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. So today I have BoxyCharm Premium for May. Do you want to know what's inside? Stay tuned. Okay, you guys. So I just got my BoxyCharm and this is for May. This is the premium. I do not know where my base box is. I haven't got tracking, but then again, I didn't even get tracking for this until today and it's here. Well, I actually went to my local post office to pick it up, so I didn't wait until tomorrow, but I don't know what's going on with the base box. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do this one now. And when the base box comes in, I'll do that one later. Normally I like to do them together to show you the difference, but I don't know where that one is. So here we go. Here it is. When we get inside, BoxyCharm Premium. You have this, and that is what it looks like inside. Now, last month I was able to choose, I think, a product for my base box, but I could not figure out how to choose a product for my premium box. So I didn't even get to choose a product for my premium, but let's go ahead and see. I don't even have a card. There's not even a card in here, so I'm not gonna be able to tell you the pricing. I'm not gonna be able to tell you my variation. I'm not gonna be able to tell you anything. But what's inside the box? So let's just go ahead and start diving in and seeing what these little guys are here first that I'm seeing. This says Sugar Rush Tarte Best Bud Lip Butter Balm. So we have a lip balm. It looks like it is in peony. And let's see here. So that is that. Oh my gosh, look at that. The packaging is super cute. How cute is that? So it says Sugar Rush with this really pretty flower on the top and it's yellow. That is super cute. And then there's just like a standard lip balm. Ooh, that smells so good. So that is cute. I love the packaging on that as well. So there's that. I don't know how much it is. The next little guy is by Milk Makeup. It's this little thing here and it says Glow Oil Lip and Cheek. Lip and Cheek? I normally, things I put on my lips, I don't put on my cheeks and vice versa, but it's called Flare. And that's what it looks like. I'm not going to open that all the way. It's like a pinkish color in there. I don't even know what this thing is. So I don't know what to do with it. So I don't even want to open it. So here is that. And again, it says Glow Oil Lip and Cheek. Next product here is 24 Hour Super Brow Long Wear Pomade by Kat Von D. This is in the color medium brown. So there's the top of the packaging and on the inside there is a dark brown and you just use like a angled brush and hook up your brows with that. So that's cool. So we have Kat Von D and at least it is like a dark brown, which is my color. So now let's start getting into the more bigger boxes. This one is an ampoule. It says Pure Heals by Nature Village. It just says soothing ampoule after cleansing, even out skin tone with the toner and apply a moderate amount of the product to your face. Gently pat for better absorption. So it would be nice if I had a paper to get some more information. And that is what it looks like. It is a clear solution inside. I can actually see little bubbles from my lights, but there's a liquid and it has a little suction dropper. So there's that. Now we have is by Skin & Co. Truffle Therapy Eye Concentrate. This brand does go around. I have a toner and something else from this brand with the Truffle Therapy. And this says, what do you do? After cleansing your face and using Truffle Therapy Serum, use your ring finger to apply a generous amount of the Truffle Therapy Eye Concentrate under eye. So it's an under eye product. So I really cannot stand when companies do this. They give you this nice big old box and then it's like, ooh, we're gonna have some nice little good sized product inside. And then you go and you take out the smallest little thing that they can probably put in there. Like they had to put in so much packaging on the inside just to hold this little tiny thing. So there you go. just make a smaller box. I mean, you don't gotta lie. Once we get in it, we're gonna see what's in there. It smells like coconut. Kind of smells like a tropical. Yeah, it smells kind of tropical, which it smells nice. So then under eye cream. So that's really neat in this big old box. A wasted product. And then the last item in here is a Too Faced Natural Matte. And I have to look at the packaging to see if I have this one, because I have a lot from Too Faced. It does have a line right across the barcode. Let's see. Natural Matte. I don't know if I have this. But that's what the outside packaging looks like. And then the inside is just all matte colors. I know I have something that's a matte, so I'm not sure if this is the one that I have or not. So I'll have to check my arsenal and see. But this is by Too Faced, which again, I do collect Too Faced palettes. I do like their formula. And is there a little, yes. I love when they give you these little brochures, because then it gives you some ideas on what you can do. There's that. So that is everything that came in my BoxyCharm Premium. I don't know which variation I am. I don't know. I don't know what the total box value is. I don't know. This is $35 a month with free shipping. Definitely worth my $35 for sure. So again, we have the natural palette that I have to check to see if I have or not. We have that by Too Faced. And then we have this Pure Heals Face Serum Ampoule. We have this really cute packaging Tarte Lip Balm. We have a Kat Von D Brow Pomade. We have a lip and cheek oil thing, I guess, there. And then you have this eye cream. So that is everything that came inside of this box, you guys. Let me know what you thought. Did you get any of the same things? Do you get BoxyCharm? Do you get BoxyCharm Premium? Let me know all the details down below. Your positive interaction means the world, and I greatly do appreciate it. I do have to let you guys know, I don't know if you've been noticing a little slowage or less videos coming out on my end. I don't know if you've noticed or not, but I've been saying I want to get a schedule for like 2 years now, and I just haven't. And now with everything that's going on and boxes slowing down and shipping later, it's actually given me time to reevaluate everything, see what boxes I want to keep, see which boxes I didn't want to keep, because I've always been cutting back, and I've cut back more. And I tell you guys, anytime I do cancel anything. So I want to get on a set schedule, and I'm going to try my best to stick to it, where I'm going to post every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And if I have any other reviews or other videos, then I can post them Saturday and Sunday if I have them. If not, then not. But definitely, for sure, post every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. I don't want you guys getting burned out of seeing this face. And there's so many unboxing videos, so I just kind of want to stick to ones that are not as much out there, or finding newer things. It's just that kind of thing. So, you know, I like to have a lot of different boxes on my channel and do different things. So I want to stick with the ones that do good on my channel, what you guys want to see. But I feel like going into a schedule would be better, especially when I am normally working. We work 6 days a week, and then I've been uploading every single day. So I'm uploading 7 days a week. I'm working a full-time job 6 days a week, and it's just become a lot for me. So if I am cutting back and I'm uploading at least 3 to 5 every week, and not 7 plus, because some days I was doing 2 different uploads a day. So I think this is going to be a really good change for me. And then you guys will know every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, definitely you will see me upload in the morning like normal. If I have something, I will definitely still do Saturdays and Sundays, but every Tuesday and Thursday will be a complete break for my channel and for me. I'm not going to be doing anything with YouTube on those 2 days. And I think it's going to be a good thing. I've been trying like the last 2 weeks to stick to the Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So I didn't post a few days last week. I didn't even post last weekend, that kind of thing. I don't know. So if you guys have noticed, that's what's going on. Plus, since we are home a little bit more right now, we've been doing a lot more like home projects that we needed to do. So I've been really, really busy with trying to do some home projects that we've been working on. I've been doing some Cricut videos so I can upload or edit those and show you guys, because I know a few of you guys have been really waiting for Cricut videos. So those are soon coming. I recorded one yesterday. I was doing something for a friend and I went to put my phone on my ring light on the stand to record what I was doing, and it was pressing and holding down one of the buttons and it was coming up with this big old screen and it was like making some siren sound and it was saying some SOS distress something or other, and I'm trying to hit cancel but it's still holding the button down firm because it was in the actual holder, and it then started like ringing. I had to pull my phone off the thing, almost broke my ring light to get my phone off. It was dialing 911. I heard it actually literally ring and I'm like, stop. And so I was like freaking out. I didn't know if like cops are going to be busting down my door, if they're going to call me back. Like, I was really paranoid for a few minutes. I'm not going to lie. I've never done that before. When I was a kid, I think I called 911 and hung up and they called right back. So I already know like they call right back to find out what's going on, but they didn't. And I heard it actually ring on my end. So I must have caught it just in time to not ring on their end, but I was really freaking out. SOS distress. My phone was, I've never heard my phone even make those sounds before. It was like an alarm, like alerting, sounded like the Titanic was going down. I don't know what in the world was going on with my phone, but I was scared the shit out of me. It scared the shit out of me. So I just wanted to let you guys know, definitely I'm going to be starting on the schedule. So Tuesdays and Thursdays, don't even try to look for me on my channel unless you want to watch old videos, but new ones will not be on there. I'm gonna definitely try to stick to that. So let me know what you guys think. Does that sound like a good thing? Every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And if I have something Saturday and Sunday, and if there are some that you don't really want to see, just let me know as well, because that'll kind of help me decide what other ones to still kind of cut back on, that kind of thing. So there you have it. So thank you guys so much again for tuning in and now listening to my little story. That's all I have now for you. So until next time, you know that drill. Keep a smile on that gorgeous face of yours, and I will see you on the next one. Bye. Crafty Crew out.